OK。
OK， good day。
我们可以开始啊。
啊，可以了。
OK， Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya。
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 So we are going through fifth canto, chapter one, the activities of Maharaj Priyavrata.
我们继续来阅读《圣典博迦瓦坛》第五篇第一章 ，Priyavrata 王的活动。
And we heard how Maharaj Priyavrata was the eldest son of Swayambhuva Manu, but he'd gone off to the mountains to do meditation and austerities with Narada Muni.
Priyavrata 王，他是 Swayambhuva Manu 的长子，但是他和 Narada Muni 一起去了山顶，去那里冥想苦行。
So, in the absence of Priyavrata, his brother, Maharaj Uttanapada, became the ruler.
他不在的时候，他的弟弟 Uttanapada 成为了统治者。
And after some time, Uttanapada also, you know, left the world and other people took over. But after some time, there was no suitable person to become the king. To become the ruler in the place of Swayambhuva Manu. Swayambhuva Manu wanted to retire.
但是过了一段时间，乌特纳帕达离开了这个世界，这样呢就没有一个合适的统治者代替斯瓦扬布瓦曼努来统治世界。
So Swayambhuva Manu came to ask his son Priyavrata.To come back and take over and become the ruler.
In此 Swayambhuva Manu 就前来找他的长子，请求他回去来接管这个世界。
But Narada Muni was thinking that if he went back, if he went back to become the king, he would have to become married. He'd have to get married, enter into family life.And it would be very difficult for him to keep up his spiritual practice.
Narada Muni 就想，如果他要是回去当国王的话，就会结婚生子，成家立业，对于他的灵性修行来说就困难了。
So Narada Muni wasn't in favor of Priyavrata going back.
所以 Narada Muni赞同 Priyavrata 回去。
So it was at this time Lord Brahma came, because Swayambhuva Manu had gone there to the mountains to see Priyavrata and Narada Muni, and while Swayambhuva Manu was there, at that time Lord Brahma also came.
这时候呢 ，Swayambhuva Manu 就在山上和 Narada Muni 以及他的儿子 Priyavrata 在一起。就在这一时刻，主 Brahma 也来了。
And Brahma came along with great sages and the personified Vedas. They all came with Brahma on his swan carrier.
那些圣人们连同伟达经的人格化身，也陪同着主 Brahma。坐在天鹅座驾上的主 Brahma 一起降临了。
Right. Lord Brahma, his carrier is the swan. Lord Shiva's carrier is the bull, Nandi.
主 Brahma 的座驾是天鹅，而主 Shiva 的座驾是一头公牛，名字叫 Nandi.
But there's a very special temple.In Navadvip Dham, which is called Hamsavahan, where Lord Shiva came on the swan.
在马古纳瓦对普丹有一个特殊的庙，名字叫 Hamsa Vahan。
Yes.
就是在这个庙里头住 Shiva 坐着，曾经坐着他的座驾来到这里。
Lord Shiva, usually he comes on the bull, but the bull is very slow. So he wanted to come very fast. So he got Lord Brahma's swan to take him.
一般呢，主 Shiva 他会坐着他的公牛，但是因为牛走得很慢，所以这次呢，为了加快速度，主 Shiva 就坐着 Brahma 的座驾，那个天鹅就来了。
So Lord Shiva was very eager to hear Gaura Katha. Gaura Bhagavat was being spoken, and Lord Shiva was very eager to hear it. So he came quickly on the swan of Lord Brahma.
主 Shiva 渴望聆听 Gaura Katha, Gaura Bhagavat, 所以他就想很快的到达，因此他就坐着天鹅就快来了。
So this time, Lord Brahma had come on the swan. He'd come there to the mountains, and he's come to mediate between the two sides, between Narada Muni and Swayambhuva Manu.
这一次呢，在山顶上，主 Brahma 他作为协调者，就来协调 Narada Muni 和 Swayambhuva Manu 之间的事情。
Because Narada Muni, he's a brahmachari, and he's in favor of brahmachari life. And he says, if you become a householder, be hopeless, you'll be fallen.
Narada Muni 呢是一位真守生，因此呢，他就比较支持真守生的生活，他并不赞成家居生活。
But Swayambhuva Manu is saying, no, you're the eldest son, it's your duty, you have to do your duty, that you should come back and do your duty, and this way you'll become perfect.
但是 Swayambhuva Manu 呢说，不行，你是长子，你得回去履行你作为长子的职责，这样你的生命才能得到完美。
So it's being explained here in this first chapter of the fifth canto how Lord Brahma is preaching to Priyavrata and he wants to encourage him.
就在第五篇的第一章，主 Brahma 就向 Priyavrata 开始传教来鼓励他。
So he tells Priyavrata that every one of us has to be obedient to the order of the Supreme Lord.
他对他说，我们每一个人都要服从至尊主的命令。
Nobody can go against the order of the Supreme, even Lord Brahma, the most senior living entity in the universe.Down to the tiniest insect, the ant, they all have to obey the orders of the Supreme Lord.
没有人能够违背至尊主的命令，从最高级的生物 Brahma 到细小的蚂蚁都要服从至尊主的命令。
It does not matter how much austerity you do or how learned you are in the Vedas.
不管你做了多少苦行，或者是在伟达经方面多么博学
，It does not matter how expert you are in mystic yoga, or how big a scholar, big brain you have.
也不管你是在神秘瑜伽方面呢多么精通，或者是你的大脑多发达，又是多么大的一个学者。
Nobody can go against the order of the Supreme Lord.
没有一个人能够违背至尊主的命令。
Because we have material bodies, Material body means also we have senses. These senses, they belong to the Supreme Lord. Material scientists may try to go against the law of the Supreme Lord, but they cannot.
物质的科学试图要违背至尊主的命令和秩序，但是他们却做不到。
Material scientists are always planning that in the future we will live longer, we won't have to die, but we see everybody dying, and the scientists are also dying.
物质的科学家们在谋划着将来能够使人们能够长寿、长生不死。
So sometimes we're proud of our education or of our austerities and penance, but actually they're useless to overcome the laws of the Supreme Lord.
以及忏悔感到骄傲自大，但这一切在至尊主的法律面前都毫无用处。
So Lord Brahma had come to advise Priyavrata that he should accept family life and he should take up the responsibility for ruling the kingdom.
主 Brahma 就建议 Priyavrata 要进入家庭生活，要接管这个统治世界的职责。
But Priyavrata knew that Narada Muni was advising him not to enter family life and not to get entangled in the material affairs. So Priyavrata should not neglect either of their instructions.
Priyavrata 不应该忽视任何一方的训示。
In other words, he should do. Lord Brahma wants him to enter family life. He should do it.
换言之，主 Brahma 希望他进入家庭生活，他就应该进入家庭生活。
And Narada Muni wants him not to get entangled in material life and become false, so he should avoid getting entangled in material life.
而那个男人的目的并不希望他卷入物质生活，所以他也不应该卷到物质生活里面。
Yeah, he should use his intelligence to satisfy both Swayambhuva Manu and Narada Muni.
他应该应用他的智慧来满足每一方面，无论是 Swayambhuva Manu 还是 Narada Muni.
This is the proper use of intelligence, and this kind of intelligence is shown to us by Rupa Goswami. He teaches that, Rupa Goswami teaches us that we should accept material things without attachment, and we should use them in the service of Krishna.
Rupa Goswami 教导我们，我们应该没有依附之心接受物质事物，用来为主 Krishna 做服务。
That is the real intelligence.
真正的智慧。
Yes. So becoming a family man or becoming a king in the material world is not a problem. It's not harmful. If we do Krishna's service.
成为一名居士，当上并不是个问题，也并对我们的服务也并没有妨害。
The Mayavadis, they say only the spiritual world, only the Brahman is true, and the material world is all false.
Mayavadi 们认为 只有 Brahman 是真实的，物质世界是虚假的。
But we do not think the world is false. We think the world is also real. Just as Brahman is real, this world is also real.
但我们不这样认为，就像 Brahman 是真实的一样，这个物质世界也同样真实。
It may be temporary, but it's real. It's not false.
它尽管短暂，但却是真实的，并非是虚假的。
But if we try to use this world for our own enjoyment, that is false. That is stupid.
但如果我们把这个物质世界用于个人的享受，那是愚蠢的行为，那是假的。
Everything is meant to be enjoyed by the Supreme Lord Krishna.
一切都应该由 Krishna 享受。
Krishna is the proprietor. Krishna is the enjoyer.
Krishna 是拥有者， Krishna 是享受者。
Everyone should know this verse in the Bhagavad Gita. It's the last verse at the end of the fifth chapter. We call it the peace formula.
每个人都应该知道《薄伽梵歌》第五章的最后一个诗节，我们称之为和平公式。
That Krishna is the supreme proprietor and the supreme enjoyer and the best friend.
Krishna 是至尊的拥有者，是享受者，是最好的朋友。
So when we use everything in his service, then we will be peaceful.
当我们把一切都用于为他做服务，内心就会平和。
That is the perfect use of one's intelligence.
这是一个人的智性的最好的利用方法。
So Lord Brahma tells Priyavrata that all the living entities accept different bodies for birth and death.
主 Brahma 告诉 Priyavrata， 一切生物体他们接受了物质的躯体，他们出生又死亡。
And with these bodies, sometimes there will be happiness, sometimes there will be distress, sometimes there will be dangers.
在这些躯体当中，他们时而快乐，时而悲伤，时而会遇到危险。
We are seeing all of these things today in the world very clearly.
我们在当今的世上清清楚楚地看到这一事实。
We have all come to this material world for material enjoyment.
我们都来到这个物质世界来进行物质享受。
And we take a body according to our karma.
根据各自的 karma 接受了不同的躯体。
Just like we have different residences. Somebody's got a villa, and somebody's got an apartment, and somebody's got a tiny little house in the country.
就像我们有不同的居所，有的人住在别墅，有人住在公寓，有的人住在乡下的一所小房子。
So we all have our different karma. We take different bodies, different situations.
因此，根据各自的 karma， 我们接受不同的躯体，处在不同的境况。
So according to the body, we act in different ways. Krishna gives us free will. We can act in different ways, but we act under the modes of nature.
各自的躯体，我们就会以不同的方式来行动。我们都有各自的不同自由意志，但是我们都处在自然属性的控制之下。
So Krishna gives us some free will. We want if we can either try to enjoy the body or we can surrender to Krishna.
Krishna 给了我们自由意志。 我们可以来享受，我们也可以用我们的躯体去臣服。
Krishna gives that independence. We either we want to have our own desires or we want to surrender to Krishna's desire.
我们有各自的独立性，我们可以按照自己的欲望去活动，我们也可以臣服于 Krishna 的意志。
So Lord Brahma tells Priyavrata, every one of us, all of us in the universe, from the top in the universe down to the bottom, we're all under the Vedic injunctions, the laws of the Vedas.
主 Brahma 告诉 Priyavrata, 我们所有人在这个宇宙之中，从最高等的到最低的地方，我们都要按照伟达的训谕去活动。
And Lord Brahma says, he said, just like the farmer, he can control the bull. They have big bulls to plow the fields, and the bull moves. They control the bull. They put a rope through the nose of the bull. And when they want to control the bull, they just pull on the rope, which goes through the nose of the bull. So in the same way, we are controlled by our duties in the Varnashram.
Chu Brahma 说，就像农民，他们有自己耕地用的公牛，他们会在公牛的鼻子上，穿上一个绳子，他们拉动这个绳子就控制着公牛。同样呢，我们也被各自的 Varnashram 当中的职责所控制着。
So that in everywhere in the world, there's different occupations. Different people have different qualities, and they do different work.
在世界各地，人们都有各自的职责，他们有各自的品性，也从事着不同的工作。
You have the brahmanas who are the intellectual class.
有 brahmana， 他们是有智慧的阶层。
They like to study, they like to read, and speak philosophy.
他们喜欢学习、读书、研究哲学。
Then you have the managers, the administrators, the kshatriyas, who like to order people and command people, tell them what to do.
还有管理阶层，那些控制者。Kshatriya, 他们喜欢发号施令，来训示别人，告诉别人该怎么做。
Then you have the Vaishyas, who like to do business. They like to make some income. They're always buying and selling.
还有 Vaishya, 从事着商业活动，他们喜欢，他们在不停的买卖，喜欢收入。
Even farmers, they keep also the cows. That's also Vaishya work.
农民们他们会养母牛，这也属于 Vaishya 的工作。
And somebody else's nature is to be the worker. He's told what to do.
还有另外一些人呢，他们本性上是劳工，他们是接受别人的命令来去从事一些活动。
And so everyone has a nature according to how we associate with the modes of nature and according to our karma from the past life. We have a particular nature. We do things we like to do.
因此我们都有各自的本性，有各自的职责，就根据我们前世的活动，我们喜欢从事于特定的工作。
So the body we get is connected to the previous life.
我们现今的当今的躯体是跟上一世的活动有关系。
So some people say you have to be born in a Brahmana family to be a Brahmana.
有的人声称你必须要投生于一个 Brahmana 家庭才可以成为一名 Brahmana。
But other people say, well, the previous birth doesn't matter. In this life, in this life, we can change our qualities and we can change our way of working.
但另外别的人又说，上一世我们上一世的活动并没有什么关系，我们在这一生当中可以改变我们的品质。
Just like in our Krishna consciousness movement, we have people doing Brahmanical work, but they are not born in Brahmana families.
正如我们的 Krishna 这些运动当中呢，有一些人从事着 Brahmana 的工作，但他们并非投生于 Brahmana 家庭。
But they're very much recognized as being very Brahmanical. They're very good. They have all the Brahmanical qualities.
但是公认他们是拥有着Brahmana 的品质。
And on the other hand, you have people who are born in a Brahmana family, and they give up all the Brahminical culture and they go and work in the job somewhere. They do sudra work.
另一方面呢，我们看到有一些人，他们放弃了 Brahmana 的文化，他们去从事着别的工作。
So this is discussed in the 7th canto Srimad Bhagavatam. Narada Muni was talking to Maharaj Yudhisthira.
在圣典薄伽瓦坛第七篇当中， Narada Muni 和 Yudhisthira 的对话当中就谈论了这一切。
And Narada Muni told Maharaj Yudhisthira, if a person is born in a Brahmana family, has the symptoms of a sudra,then he is not a Brahmin, he's a Sudra.
Narada Muni 告诉 Yudhisthira, 倘若一个诞生于 Brahmana 家庭当中的人拥有 Sudra 的品性，那他应该是从事 Sudra 的工作。
And if somebody is born in a Sudra family but has Brahminical qualities, he should be known as a Brahmana.
另一方面，倘若人出生于Sudra 家庭却拥有 Brahmana 的品性，那应该认为他是一个 Brahmana。
So we need these different sections of society. If everyone is just simply a worker, a Sudra, then it is not very good for the society, not very good for the world.
因此，我们需要这个世界上有不同的阶层。如果人人都是从事都是工人，那对这世界并不好。
So, following our duty according to the Varnashram system is very pleasing to Krishna.
因此，按照我们在 Varnashram 制度当中来遵行各自的职责，这一点非常能取悦 Krishna.
Everyone's meant to worship the Supreme Lord.
人人都应该崇拜至尊主。
But unfortunately, today people don't worship Krishna. They worship only money. They worship the material energy. They're not worshiping God.
但很不幸，当今的人们不崇拜 Krishna， 他们是拜金主义，他们并不崇拜神。
They think.The advanced civilization is to build big skyscraper buildings and to have many cars on the road. But the goal of life is not that. The goal of life is to get free of birth and death.
并不是这样，生命的目标是摆脱生死。
So it's important to understand the real purpose of this human life.
因此，去理解这个人体生命的重要性是非常，人体生命的目的是很重要的。
So we should understand that just because you're a Brahmana, it doesn't mean you're better than other people.It just means you have a different duty.
我们要明白，Brahmana 并不意味着他就会比别人强。 只是各自的分工不同而已。
And not only the brahmanas are supposed to be elevated to go to the higher position, but the sudras also, everybody supposed to go to the higher position by working for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord.
不仅仅 brahmana 可以被提升到更高的地位上，sudra 也可以提升到更高的地位上，他们只要为 Krishna 的快乐，至尊者的快乐而工作。
So just like these big bulls, they can be controlled by a little boy because the rope is right through their nose. So they do whatever way the boy pulls the rope. So in the same way, we should be controlled by the Vedas.
即便公牛非常强壮，但一个小男孩却可以轻而易举地拉动这个绳子来控制公牛。因此，我们同样的应该被维达经所控制着。
Yeah, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Yashastradvidimutrijya vartate kamakarata nasasadim avapnoti nasukam naparamgatim. If we do not follow the teachings of the scriptures, then we will never be successful in our life.
《薄伽梵歌》中主 Krishna 说，倘若我们不遵从经典的训谕，生命就永远不会成功。
We will never be happy, and we will never get the supreme destination.
我们永远不会快乐，也永远不会到达至尊的目的地。
So Lord Brahma encourages Priyabrata that give up this desire for your own happiness, and just understand happiness and distress comes to everybody in every situation.
主 Brahma 就鼓励 Priyavatava 放弃他自己想要快乐的愿望，因为在这个世界上人人都会快乐也会痛苦。
Lord Brahma says, just like a blind man is led by a man who can see, so we're like the blind man, and the Krishna is like the man with the eyes. He's leading us. We should just follow his direction.
主 Brahma 说，就像一个盲人，他被一个能够双眼能够看见的人所指引。我们就像那个盲人，而 Krishna 就是那位能够看见的人，因此我们都要遵从 Krishna 的指引。
We cannot change our destiny. All of us, we will get some happiness, we will get some distress. It's already arranged. We can't change.
我们不能改变自己的命运，我们会快乐，有的时候又会感到痛苦。这一切都无法改变。
So we just have to surrender to the desire of the Supreme Lord.
因此，我们只要臣服至尊主的愿望和意志。
So this is the real perfection of life. When we start to take the direction from the scriptures come from the Lord, and we're following His direction. So that is perfection in life.
因此，我们就需要在生命当中遵从经典的指示，这是我们生命的完美。
So every one of us can surrender, not only the Brahmins, the Kshatriya, the Vaishya, the Sudra, everyone can surrender.
人人都可以皈依，无论是 Brahmana, Kshatriya, 还是 Vaishya, 人人都应当臣服。
Krishna is speaking Bhagavad Gita for everyone. He said, even you be of lower birth, you can achieve the supreme destination.
Krishna 向每个人讲述这一薄伽梵歌，即便是出生低等，仍然可以达到至尊的目的地。
So we shouldn't worry about happiness or try to avoid distress. We should just be satisfied with whatever plan Krishna has for us.
我们无需要努力的去追求快乐，逃避痛苦，我们只需要遵从主 Krishna 给我们的计划。
The more we're in the mode of passion and ignorance, then we cannot understand the plan of Krishna.
我们越是处于激情属性和愚昧属性之下，就越不能明白至尊主给我们的计划。
But in this human life, we have a good opportunity to surrender to Krishna and to be properly engaged in His service.
在这个人类躯体当中，我们有很好的机会可以臣服 Krishna， 来从事于 Krishna 给我们的服务。
Like everybody can chant the holy name, and they can come to understand their real position through chanting the holy name.
人人都可以唱诵圣名，通过唱诵圣名明白他们各自的地位。
So.It's important for us to be satisfied in whatever position we've been put by the plan of Krishna.
因此，我们很重要的一点是，无论 Krishna 把我们置于什么样的境地当中，我们都应该心满意足。
And everyone should try to do devotional service.
而且人人都应该从事奉献服务。
Right.Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, the confidential knowledge, four things. He said, use your mind to think of me, become my devotee, offer obeisances to me, worship me.
Krishna 在薄伽梵歌当中讲述了机密的知识，心意恒常想着我，为我做服务，顶拜我，崇拜我。
So, some enjoyment.Comes, some suffering comes, we should understand this is our karma and just accept it. Just like when you have a dream at night, in the dream, so many things happen in dream. But when we wake up, we don't worry about what happened in the dream.
都是我们的 karma 而已，我们只需要接受。就像我们晚上会做梦，但当我们又醒来之后，我们就不太担心我们梦里的那些情景了。
So the liberated, you know, liberated soul knows he's not the body. He understands his spirit soul, different from the body.
解脱的灵魂明白，他们不是这个物质躯体。
So Priyavrata, he was already advanced in spiritual knowledge. He doesn't want to be a conditioned soul again. He doesn't want to become conditioned again.
Priyavrata, 他在灵性方面已经是进步了的，所以他不想再受条件限制，成为受条件限制的灵魂。
So Priyavrata may be worried that, you know, if he's going to...come back and be the king and ruler and become a family man, maybe he would again fall under all this material energy and become entangled.
Priyavrata 就担心，如果他要是回去统治世界，成为国王，又娶妻生子，他可能再次堕入这个自然能量的控制当中。
But Lord Brahma, he's telling Priyavrata that even the liberated souls, they know they have some past activities, and they accept the result, they accept whatever results are there from their past activities.
但是 Brahma 告诉 Priyavrata 吧，即便是解脱了灵魂，他们也知道他们有前世的活动，所以他们也接受他们前世活动的结果。
There's a saying, we say, every saint has a past.
有句谚语叫做每一个圣人都有他们的过去的历史。
And every sinner has a future.
而每一个罪人都 都有未来。
So, even liberated, Lord Brahma says, even the liberated souls, they don't resent that, that they have to, you know, that in the present body, there's get some results from their past activities.
So, even the liberated souls, they don't resent that, that they have to, you know, that in the present body, there's get some results from their past activities. So, even the liberated souls, they don't resent
that, and gives the example, just like when you dream. Yeah, so things happen in the dreams, they're not real, but you don't worry about them.
打个比喻，我们都会做梦，但是梦是不真实的，所以我们无需为这个梦境而担心。
So a liberated person doesn't, he's only thinking, he does his duty, he does his activities at the present, and he doesn't worry about what kind of things happen due to the past.
解脱的灵魂呢，他们只是履行自己的职责，当下的职责，他们并不担心，并不太在意他们过往都从事了些什么活动。
If we work for the Supreme, then there's no reaction.
倘若我们为至尊者而活动，就没有业报反应。
In the past, we may have done things ignorantly, we did things the wrong way in the past, and we may have to suffer some reaction for that.
过去也许我们做了愚蠢的活动，错误的行为，我们要为此而遭受一些反应。
But we should go on and do our work at the present so that in the future we don't get another body.
但是我们应该继续我们当下的工作，好将来不再获得一个物质的躯体。
If we do devotional service in this life, it doesn't matter what we did in our past life. We will always get a good destination in the future.
只要我们在这一生从事奉献服务，无论我们前一世从事了什么活动，那也都无所谓，我们都会有一个好的光明的未来。
The idea is after we give up this body, then we should not accept another material body. We should go back to Godhead.
要点就是当我们放弃当下的这个躯体之后，我们将来就不再接受另一个物质躯体了。
And in this life, we're just working off our karma from the past, from before we became devotees.
、
In this life,we're working to get rid of the karma which we had from before.
Okay, so in this life, our work is to get rid of our previous karma.
Just like in Srimad Bhagavatam, there's a story about the king who got cursed by.Lord Shiva's wife, Parvati. There was a great king who came and he saw Lord Shiva sitting with his wife, embracing her, and he laughed at Lord Shiva, and Lord Shiva's wife was angry and she cursed him to become a demon.
圣典薄伽瓦坛当中就讲了一个故事，有一个国王，他看见主 Shiva 和他的妻子 Parvati就坐在一起，主师吧拥抱他的妻子，于是呢，他就笑了，结果帕巴提诅咒他投生为一个恶魔。
So that king, as a, you know, he was cursed, he had to become a great demon called Vritasura, and he, as a demon, he had to fight the demigods.
所以这个名叫 Vritasura 的大恶魔不得不和半神人们作战。
But Vritrasura, in the demon body, he understood that this was how he was getting rid of all of his karma so that he could go back to Godhead.
但是处在恶魔躯体当中的维特苏尔知道，他这么做，他只能这么做来摆脱他过往的 karma， 以便回归神手。
So our past life, we have some little bits of karma, and it can be all finished. It has to be all finished before we go back to Godhead.
因此，我们过往的生生世世的karma 必须全部的勾销，我们才能够回归神手。
So then Lord Brahma gives a very nice example. He says that somebody may leave the home and go to the forest, but if he cannot control his mind and senses, he won't be peaceful in the forest.
主 Brahma 就举了例子，就像一个离家出走去森林的人。倘若他不能控制自己的心意和感官，那也是没用的。
So, family life, if one has control over his mind and senses, even his in family life, it will not be any difficulty for him.
所以在家居生活当中，倘若能够控制。
But if one cannot control his senses, then in family life it will be a big problem. Doesn't matter where you are, if you go to the forest or family life, if you've not controlled your senses, you will not be happy, you will not be peaceful.
无论在哪里，这不是一个问题。进去了森林，如果不能控制感官的话，也不能获得平和。
So somebody says, "I'm going to be a yogi. I'm going to the forest." Control their mind and senses, then it's stupid.
有人说我要去森林当一名瑜伽师，如果他不能控制感官和心的话，这是愚蠢的。
He will take his mind, his uncontrolled mind and his senses will go with him to the forest. And he'll have problems in the forest. So sometimes people are in family life and they say, oh, I'm going to give up family life, I'm going to renounce.But they don't have control over their mind and senses.
Sorry, Mara, it's a little bit broken.
Okay, sorry. If someone is maybe in the family life, he may be married in family life, and he tries to give up family life, but he doesn't have control over his mind and senses.So he will simply have more trouble.
一个已经处于家庭生活当中的人，倘若他要是放弃他的家庭生，但如果他不能控制感官心的话，遇到更大的麻烦。
So very important. People have to be trained to control the mind and senses. Then.They can be very successful in family life.
非常重要的是，人应当受到训练，控制心意和感官，那么他的家庭生活就会是成。
People have to engage the sense to the way to control the mind and senses is to use them in the service of Krishna.
控制心意和感官的方法。就是将心意和感官用于服务 Krishna.
So even one is in the Grihastha family life, there's no harm if he's controlling the mind and senses.
即便是在家居生活当中，倘若控制了感官和心意的话，家居生活也并不能做出什么伤害。
So there were many great householders who had families and who did wonderful service for Krishna.
有很多伟大的居士，他们在家居生活当中为 Krishna 做出了巨大的服务。
So the senses are definitely a, they can be our enemies if they're not controlled.
倘若感官没有受到控制的话，那无疑就成为了我们的敌人。
They are just like snakes or serpents.But when you cut out the poison from the serpent, then it's no longer harmful.
就像有蛇，如果把毒液从这个蛇身上拿走的话，那么这条毒蛇也就没有防，也就没有伤害了。
So the senses are not harmful when they're used in the service of Krishna.Haribol? Haribol? Guru Mani?
Yes, Maharaj, I'm here. I can hear you.
Okay, did you translate that sentence?
Yeah, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes, if we...
So devotees in Krishna consciousness can be in the material world. They can be in family life or they can be single.But the important thing is they must control their senses and mind by using them in Krishna's service.
所以在 Krishna 之觉当中的奉献者们，他们可能身处物质世界，他们也许是居士，也可能是独身，但倘若他们控制了心意和感官，那么就没有什么伤害。
So that is the transcendental position.Okay, so we'll stop here and ask if there's any questions.
好，那我们今天晚上讲到这里，我们看问一下什么问题。
Hare Krishna.
啊，OK，我们这儿现在收到一个问题。人是怕不问的。感谢马哈拉扎，感谢翻译和主持。Priyavata 接受 Brahma 的训示，是否违背了他的灵性导师 Narada 的训示？此事件是特例吗？毕竟经典中说不能违背灵性导师的训示。
Okay, so we have to understand.That Narada Muni is not the only guru. Lord Brahma also came, and Lord Brahma is the guru of Narada Muni.
We must understand Narada Muni is not the only guru. Now, Lord Brahma has come, and Lord Brahma is Narada Muni's guru.
And after Narada Muni heard Lord Brahma's teaching and instruction, Narada Muni was happy and he accepted it.
Narada Muni 听完主 Brahma 的教导之后，他感到很快乐、高兴，他就欣然接受了。
We explained in the course of this lecture that.Priyavrata has to use its intelligence to satisfy both Narada Muni and Swayambhuva Manu. So Narada Muni wants that Priyavrata will not become fallen.He will not become entangled in material life. So that's very good. And Brahma says, you won't. We guarantee that. We won't allow that to happen to you.
Narada Muni, he doesn't want Priyavrata to become entangled into material life. And Brahma, he assured Priyavrata won't be entangled into material life.
Swayambhuva Manu is also like the guru, Swayam Bhuva Manu is the father and Narada Muni is the uncle. They're both like guru. They're both gurus. One is a seminal guru, one is a more spiritual guru. But Brahma is above both of them. So Brahma is explaining to Priyavrata how, when he goes back, he will not, because he's already trained to control the mind and senses. So even though he goes into family life, he won't fall down, because he's trained to control the mind and senses. And we have to understand there's the instruction from the Supreme Lord, Brahma, Supreme in the universe, and he's directing everyone according to the Vedas, which are the direction of the Supreme Lord. Brahma is the supreme in the universe. He's the head, he's the first person in the universe. So he's the authority in the universal affairs.
Brahma is the
And he is instructing according to the Vedic scriptures which come from the Lord. So there's a particular duty for Priyavrata which he has to take up for the welfare of the universe. But he will not fall into material life. And we say, if someone is trained in brahmachari life, they will make a good householder. Somebody who is not a good brahmachari, they won't be a good householder. Let me see, somebody's, you know, a womanizer, he's not satisfied, different relationships with different women, he can't fix his mind on one woman. He's not a good householder. But somebody who is trained in brahmachari life, then they can be satisfied, they can be fixed in householder life. So, because they've controlled their mind and senses. And later on, they can renounce. So sometimes, Priyavrata, it's pointed out, Priyavrata, maybe something from his past life, according to his karma, that it's arranged that he should go into householder life. But it's not a problem. He's not going to suffer because of it.
是一个问题，他不会为此而受苦。
Because he's already been trained. Narada Muni trained him how to be a good, how to control the mind and senses.
因为 Narada Muni 训练了他怎样控制感官与心意。
So when he becomes a family man in householder life, he will not be disturbed.
因此，当他在家庭生活当中成为一名居士的话，他的心意就不会受到骚扰。
And so Krishna arranged like this for Priyavrata.
Krishna 为 Priyavrata 做出了这样的安排。
Okay, is it clear? The devotee can be a stronger person if they have already experienced family life. Sometimes if they have not experienced family life,then it can be difficult for them to go ahead in their spiritual practice.
奉献者，他们在经历了家庭生活之后，可以变成一个更加强有力的人，因为他们体验了这个困难之后，在灵修上就可以勇往直前。
Sometimes people think maybe they miss something by not becoming a householder.
有的人以为他们没有成为居士，他们可能失去了某种体验。
Okay, any other questions here?
Yes. Good day.
啊，还有呢？
是的，下一个还是染人的爬布的问题。对于 Priyavrata 王，而言，他控制了感官，无论他是尊者生还是居士都一样。无论他去到哪儿都一样，对于我们正在练习控制心意和感官的人，是否也要选择有利于控制心意和感官的地点和环境呢？不能什么地方都去，什么样的人都交往，对吗？
I didn't get the last part of it.
For Priyavrata, Grihastha life and Brahmachari life is the same because he has been trained to control mind and senses. But for us, we have to choose the place and the situation and also the person we are going to deal with.
Well, we try to choose, but actually it's not our choice because these things are arranged by the material nature.
We try to choose, but these things are arranged by the material nature.
The material nature puts us into different situations, into different kinds of association. We don't have so much choice.
给我们的联谊以及我们的处境已经安排好了，我们没有什么好选择的。
The illusion, we're thinking, we're arranging, we're thinking, we're planning, we're putting ourselves, but it's all arranged by the higher authorities.
在幻象中，我们以为我们选择，我们可以安排我们的处境，但这都是高等的权威安排的。
So the point was made that we should be satisfied in whatever position we're in.
So the 要点就是无论我们处于哪种处境，我们都应该心满意足。
We have to control the mind and senses by engaging them in Krishna's service.
我们要将心意和感官用于做奉献服务。从而控制心意感官。
Then it doesn't matter what situation we're in.
那么无论我们处于何种处境，那都无所谓了。
Doesn't matter if we're in heaven or hell or liberation, it's all the same.
不管是在天堂、地狱还是解脱，都一样。
We're just here to do some service for Krishna for some time. And when Krishna wants, he'll take us out from this situation. Krishna puts us into one situation and he takes us out and puts us in another situation. We just have to surrender to Krishna and Krishna's plan. The illusion is to think that I'm making my situation. No, it's all about Krishna. And Krishna arranges according to our desire and our karma.
Krishna is 根据我们的愿望和根据我们的 karma 的安排。
So we have to make the best of every situation. Take it to our advantage by doing devotional service. Yes. Okay. Sati, how you want him?
是的，还有问题，好多问题呢。下一个问题，禀拜 Guru， 感谢翻译。您刚才说生命的目标是摆脱生死，这是意味着解脱吗？在《奉爱甘露》中说，纯粹的奉献者甚至嘲笑解脱的快乐，该怎么理解这两个问题？
Can you translate?
Just now you mentioned that the goal of our life is to get rid of birth and death. But in the our devotion, it said that pure devotees even derive the concept of liberation. So how to understand this point?
Yes, well, it works both ways. Sometimes Prabhupada would say, you know, don't worry about liberation, and other times Prabhupada would say you should be determined not to come back here. We have to become pure devotees. And in order to become pure devotees, we have to be aware of the misery of birth and death in the material world. There was one devotee, she was a book distributor, and she said to Prabhupada, she had some disease, she was dying. She said, Prabhupada, I just want to come back again and distribute your books. But Prabhupada said to her, you don't have to do that, just go back to Godhead. So, you know, don't worry about it. In order to become pure devotees, we have to be convinced there's no happy, we don't want to come back in this world, but at the same time, we're surrendered to Krishna. If Krishna wants us to come again, we'll come. So on the platform, when you're a pure devotee, then you can think it doesn't matter whether you come back again. But in order, first we have to become pure devotees. And to become pure devotees, we have to be convinced of the misery of birth and death in the material world. Okay, 下一个问题。
好的，下一个问题，Data Vati， 马德基，顶拜咕噜，感恩翻译，请问咕噜，是不是只有专注做奉爱服务时，才能控制感官呢？机械的去做，是不是很难控制感官？
Yes, difficult to control the senses.That we have to be fully concentrated in controlling the senses. Huh?
Yes, and mechanical service.
Yes, well,
cannot.
We can use our senses mechanically so long as your mind is focused on Krishna.Just like you may be cleaning or you may be teaching yoga or something, you can do that mechanically, but in your mind you should be thinking of Krishna. We should be hearing the holy name.Yeah, senses use, we may use the senses mechanically, but keep the mind fixed on Krishna. Maharaj Ambarish used all of his senses in the service of Krishna.Okay, so he would smell the flowers offered to Krishna. And he would hear the glories of Krishna from the scriptures. So you don't want to hear mechanically, you want to hear very carefully. If you hear mechanically,then you will not get much benefit from the hearing because you won't remember. Prabhupada said everything depends on our attitude, so we must have the right attitude in performing our devotional service.If you are using your senses mechanically, that's not devotional service. Because devotional service means to think of Krishna, to do it for Krishna.Okay. 下一个问题。
下一个问题，顶拜咕噜，感谢翻译。佛家梵歌中说，父母的职责是使子女，就是让孩子具有 Krishna 知觉。那么在奉献者的家庭当中，孩子对父母的责任是什么？
孩子
对责是什么？
孩子对父母
的职责是什么？
孩子的责。So the duty of the child to the mother and father.Is to serve them, to be obedient to them. Just like we see Krishna as a young child serving his mother and father. we see Krishna as a child serving his mother and father.
Oh, 我们看到就 Krishna 他小的时候他怎样服务他的父母。
Krishna would carry the shoes of on his head.
Krishna 会把他父亲的鞋顶在自己的头上。
So the child has a duty to the mother and father to try to keep the, help them and care for them in Krishna consciousness.
子女对于父母的职责就是帮助父母，照顾父母。Krishna 之举。
Lord Chaitanya went to visit one family, and the family had a young son.And the young son wanted to come with Lord Chaitanya. But Lord Chaitanya told the young boy, he said, no, you stay here with your mother and father, and you take care of them. After they leave the world, then you come.
Chaitanya, 他有一次呢，在一个家庭当中，有一个小男孩，他就想跟着主 Chaitanya 一起走，但是主 Chaitanya 就命令他，你不要这样做，你留在家里照料你的父母，等他们离世之后，你再跟随我。
So it depends on the situation. We see, for example, another devotee, Raghunath Das, he ran away from home, left his home. Lord Chaitanya accepted him.
这要取决于不同的情况。另外一个奉献者 Raghunath Das 他就离开了家就跑了，但是主 Chaitanya 接受了他。
Initially Lord Chaitanya told him to stay at home and not to act like a foolish person but just to keep Krishna in his heart.
一开始呢，主 Chaitanya 命令他留在家，但是呢不要那么愚蠢，但是把 Krishna 放在心中。
But after some time, then the Raghunath he ran away from home and he came to Lord Chaitanya. So Lord Chaitanya accepted him.
但是过了一段日子，Raghunath Das 就离家出逃了，就去找主 Chaitanya， 主 Chaitanya 接受了他。
And Lord Chaitanya told him, you're very lucky to be freed from the material life. Because his family was very rich. So Lord Chaitanya said, not a pleasant atmosphere for Krishna consciousness.
So Lord Chaitanya said, this for Krishna consciousness is not a very pleasant atmosphere.
So it will depend in different situations. If one is the only child, then the mother and father are more dependent on the care of the child.
This depends on different situations, different families. If one is the only child,那父母肯定是要依赖这个孩子的照顾。
下一个问题。
下一个问题，Gurudev， 您刚才在这个讲课当中就说了，我们应该接受自己的这个自然品性而给我们确定的这种社会的阶层。那在这个卡利年代，我们每个人都是处在这个苏卓的这个阶层，但是我们往往都不太愿意接受这个位置，总是想做查却雅，想管理别人，然后总是想做婆罗门去教导别人。那我们如何改变这种心态呢？全然的接受自己的这个仆人的苏卓的位置呢
？Well, we may.Our nature may not be to be a sudra. Prabhupada's explaining that there are different divisions of society and some people can be they can have a Brahminical nature and they should be recognized as Brahmins. Of course, it's different for women. Now, women have a special dharma, stri dharma, the duties of a woman. Women are not Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. These positions are for men. So men, there's a statement in the scripture that anyone can become a brahmana if they're properly initiated and trained by a bona fide spiritual teacher. And similarly, Kshatriya. You have a Kshatriya nature, you're inclined to the Kshatriya, you have to be trained to do the work of the Kshatriya. So even in a socialist country, a communist society, we see somebody is, you know, a manager and somebody's a worker. Not everybody is a worker. There are other people with managerial positions, there are people doing business, there are intellectuals. So, according to our karma and our desire, we work in a particular situation and we take up a duty in some particular varna. But it's not eternal. That position is not eternal. And what is important is that we work for Krishna, that we use our senses in Krishna's service. Everyone should become transcendental by serving Krishna. Don't just simply be in nirvana, doing your varna, but work for Krishna. Are you wanting more?
没有了，我的今天的最后一个问题已经回答过了，没有更多的问题了。OK，OK，所以我们今天结束了。
So thank you very much.
好了。Thank
you for your translation, Guru Mani. Thank you, Sati, for being a host.
Thank you, Maharaj.
OK, so have a good weekend. Juni, how's it? Oh, 周末啊
对，明天是周末 谢谢Gurudev的讲课，然后给我们回答了这么多问题。
Hare Krishna Srila Prabhupada Ki Srimad Bhagavad Ki Jai God Premanande Haribo
Haribo